Scorpio, relax, take it easy, and enjoy your 10 card Celtic cross. I'm just shuffling cards. Split a deck. Then I'll start your reading. Right. So, your current position, Scorpio, is a Two of Cups. Right. Now, Two of Cups is the soulmate card. Right. It's finding your perfect partner. It's a knowing that you found your perfect partner, or you found your perfect career or work situation in life. Difficulties facing you is it Eight of Wands. Right, so the Eight of Wands and the difficulties facing you is that there's communication coming in towards you fast, right? Telephone calls, emails, texts that are affecting your soulmate relationship, good or bad, right? If you and your soulmate or your work situation is going well, then there's news coming in which could affect it, good or bad. But the difficulties is that the word difficulty, it's going to be something bad you're going to hear in relation to your soulmate or work situation. Your current concerns is the King of Swords, right? So you're thinking, male or female, are you handling the situation correctly, or is the other party handling it? Situation correctly? Because when you get to soulmates, it's not just like a normal boyfriend girlfriend relationship, if you like. It's, there's telepathic connections, it's deeper than that. When you find your soulmate, you know, right? And your current concerns is with the King of Swords, are you being too standoffish, or is the partner being standoffish in your communications? Even if there's no communication in the normal sense of communicating, there is telepathy, right, in your love life and in your work connections. So you might be questioning, in your concerns, have you been too harsh in your outlook, or have they been too harsh in their outlook towards you? What's passing out your life is a Chariot. So what's passing out your life is a fear, not thinking you're in control, right? You're in control. And that realization of the fear of not being in control is passing out your life. And you're realizing that you're in control. The positive and negative aspects of the situation, you're handling well. in your recent past, we have the High Priestess. So in your recent past, en route to your soulmate connection, right? This deeper understanding in a relationship or a work situation, if you're not into relationships, right? You achieved the status of the High Priestess, right? Somebody that has been through a lot in life, a lot of trials, a lot of tests, half a universe, right? A lot of situations you've had to deal with. And through all of that, you felt as if you went to hell in life. But the thing about the High Priestess is, she's been to hell and back, right? And so have you. And that was in your recent past. And getting the High Priestess is a very powerful card, right? Shows you a lot of knowledge, and this is where telepathy kicks in, because you've elevated through the 3D in your normal way of thinking into the 5D, where you can connect with all. So your immediate future, we have the Five of Pentacles. Now, the Five of Pentacles in your immediate future, Scorpio, is, right, you know what you know where you're at, right, but there's still that wee bit of confusion or lack, right, and I think it's obvious here that a lack is, you're wanting your soulmate, you're wanting to build your life, and you're wanting to be happy. You're not wanting the communications coming in that upset you or make you have to deal with negative stuff in your life. You're wanting to give your heart to your soulmate or your work if you're not pursuing love. And this mindset of being impoverished in love, when you're holding yourself back through worrying about how the other person thinks or truly thinks about you and how you truly think and feel about him. Because when you think about the telepathic connection, right, you can hold it for a while, but if your soulmate's easily distracted, they can disconnect through the conversation that's going on in the 5D, and you can be left wondering and getting frustrated. And I feel that's where you are, or where you will be in the immediate future. So in the near future, we have the Queen of Wands, which is excellent, right? Now the Queen of Wands shows that you're going to be happy, realizing your full power, right? That you're beautiful, you're choosing to be happy, right? And you've got a fire and passion to drive you towards what you want, relationship or career. Your hopes and fears is, hold on, no, wait a minute, no, sorry, your influences around you, right, is this card, this is your influences around you. Your influences around you is the Three of Swords, a broken heart, right? So what we could have here, right, is you've found your soulmate, but you can't connect, or you've found your ideal working situation, but you can't get into it, right? Or you can't and you feel comfortable or secure in it, right? And you're fearing that these influences around you could cause you a broken heart, right? For example, you're fearing if you take on the full energies of the Queen of Wands, pardon me, and go towards it with your passion, love or career, then you'll end up with a broken heart through influences out with that, right? But this is with the swords all in your head, right? The swords govern intellect and thought, right? It is just a fear that could be stopped. It's shown up here as an obstacle into where you want to be when you apply your passion, love and happiness within yourself. It's just a wee bit of natural doubt, right? So your hopes and fears is the Page of Swords, right? Now, that could be for a number of reasons, right? Let's just say with this Three of Swords, you've already experienced heartache in your life, either in career or love, right? And you're fearing that if you tell people, right, because you've probably been bummed through doing it before, but you're fearing that people, you could feel you've nobody to really share it to, and I think that's God's guidance, right, to share it with who needs to hear it alone, i.e. the soulmate or the boss in a career, right? And having the Page of Swords, which is a spy card, you're fearing if you tell anybody else what's happening in your life, that they're going to go and spread rumours and gossip and let everybody know your business, which I think is a valid fear to have. And you're hoping if you've got a confidant or somebody you can trust, that they won't tell your business. So your outcome is a death card, right? So the purpose of tarot is to empower, right? To give you a look into your life situation and to make you aware of stuff that you might not otherwise have known. And the death and the outcome shows that there's going to be a death to a way of thinking, a death to a way of doing something that is hindering you going direct to what you want in life, be it your soulmate or your ideal career. This is my own cup. It's on my site that I'll put in the description if you want to buy one. There's a whole other range of apparel. You'll love it. It's all different stuff. Go and check it out. Like I said, the link will be in the description. I hope you can take some interest reading Scorpio. Please like, share and subscribe. Till next time, thanks very much.